Hello guys, myself Amrita. Welcome back to our channel Technosage. So in this video we are going to discuss problem number 3340, that is check balanced string. So let's first understand the problem. You are given a string num consisting of only digits. A string of digits is called balance if sum of digits at even indices is equal to sum of digits at odd indices. So in the example you can see we have been given one input string, that is num, which has only digits. So we need to check if sum of digits at the even is equal to sum of digits at the odd indices. We need to return true if num is balanced, otherwise we need to return false. So let's see how we are going to solve this problem. So let's take the same num string, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So we need to check sum of even indices is equal to sum of odd indices. So what is your indexes 0, 1, 2 and 3, right? So how do you know if an index is even or odd? So what is an even number? Even number is a number which is divisible by 2, right? And odd is which is not divisible by 2, right? This is what we know. So here you can see index 0. Index 0 is divisible by 2? Yes. So what would be your sum of even indices? Sum of even indices. Which are the even indices here? 0 and 2, right? So what is the number at 0? 1. What is the number at 2? 3. 1 plus 3 is 4, correct? And what is your odd indexes? Odd indexes is 1 and 3. Why? Because these are not divisible by 2. So what would be your sum at the odd indexes? What is the number at odd indexes? 2 and 4. So 2 plus 4 would be your 6. And then you need to check whether 4 is equal to 6. No, right? So then you need to return false. Why? Because sum of number at even indexes is not equal to sum of numbers at odd indexes, right? So then you need to return false. If this is equal, then you need to return true. So this is what we need to do. So one more important thing here to note is that this number is a string, right? So if this is a string, each number is a character. So we need to convert that character to integer, right? So how do we convert character to integers? Using character codes. So each integer has a character code starting from 0. So 0 has a character code of 48, 49, 50, 51, 52. So how do we convert characters to integers? Let me show you. So basically this is your character, right? So when you have to convert character to integer, you need to write num.char at I minus 0. So this will basically convert your character to integer. How? So what is your character here? 4. Character 4 minus character 0. So what is the character code of 4? 52. And what is the character code of 0? 48. So this will give you 4, but this 4 will be an integer, right? So for each character you need to convert that to integer and then you have to add to the sum. I hope you understood this. Now let's write the program for it. So this is your class, that is check balanced string. Let's write the method, that would be public static boolean. Boolean would be the return type because it is going to return true or false. Let's take the name as is balanced. And your input would be string num, right? So we need two variables to store the sum. One would be for even sum, initialize it as 0, and one would be odd sum. So let's write the loop, which would be i0, i less than num dot length, and i++, right? So for each index we are going to check whether that is an even index or odd index. So if I is divisible by 2, that means I mod 2 is equal to 0, then we are going to add that to even sum, right? Even sum plus equals to. So we don't have to add the index, we have to add the number at that index, right? So which would be num dot caret I minus 0, right? That will give us the integer value of that digit. Else we are going to add that to the odd sum, right? Odd sum plus is equals to num dot caret I minus 0, right? And at the end we are going to write the statement as odd sum is equals to even sum. So this statement will basically check if odd sum is equal to even sum, it is going to return true, otherwise it is going to return false. Now let's come back to our main function. Let's take the string num is equal to 1 2 3 4. Let's write our print statement is balanced and num, right? Let's run the program and see the output. So here one parenthesis is missing. Now let's run the program and see the output. So you can see here it is returning false. Now let's test it with another input as well, 2 4 1 2 3. So in this case it should return true. So you can see here it is returning true. Now let's copy the code, let's paste it here, let's run the program and see the output. So you can see here it is accepted, runtime is 0 milliseconds, so we can submit the code. So it is submitted successfully. So it will have a time complexity of O of n and space complexity would be O of 1. I hope you understood the solution. If you have any questions, any doubts, please let me know in the comment section. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more such videos.